Hi, welcome back. This is video 3 of Stronger Body for Running Through Natural Movements. Today we take a look at jumping. Jumping is a pure expression of power. It will improve your sprinting. It will help you jump away from approaching cars, unexpected movements, crossing a river, hopping stone to stone. It will improve your uphill running and it will prepare your body for the eccentric loads in downhill running. First of all, let's take a look at tendon elasticity. Tendon elasticity occurs with your interaction with the ground. It's the stretching and shortening of the elastic component of your muscle tendon. It's our body's ability to store and apply energy in an efficient and economical way. Crucial is the body position and the timing. The timing on the ground should be very short. How can we apply this in our running? You can see more of this in my previous video about running cadence, but this is how it looks. So, when practicing this, the intensity is low, and that means you can train a lot of volume. Skipping rope or jumps in one spot can help you tremendously to build up this elasticity, and this will help you in the run. So, now we want to take it a little bit further and explore the more explosive and power component of jumping. So, I strongly recommend to first take a look at your squat position, because squat position is actually our landing. And landing is the most important phase of our jumping, because most injuries can occur in the landing phase. So first squat, you want to make sure you always stay 60% in the heels, 40% in the front, and feet are straight and knees don't go in. So after doing a few squats, if this is okay, you can progress to light jumps in one place. You can take it higher, but start low. After that, we can go to a broad jump. This will practice your balance in landing. Again, start small, you can play with the distance later. Another good way to progress is a high jump. So, you jump up onto a step or anything else. Make sure the landing is soft and silent. Yeah? The quieter the landing means the more control you have over the landing. So, after this, you can again, you can play with the height, you can take it up a bit. Benefits of this, you need a little bit more power, but the landing will be softer because you will jump onto a height, you will not fall from that low. More difficult and more advanced is the depth jump. Because here will be more eccentric loads on the muscle. This is good, a good way for me personally to prepare for downhill running. Again, don't overdo it. The loads can go up to 7, 8 or even more times the body weight. So when we do a depth jump or any other jump, we can choose to absorb the jump. In that way, we'll be standing still, or transition into another jump. And this is also a very good way to work on that explosive movement. I will show you. Transition into another jump. Here the time on the ground is crucial. If you wait too long in the middle bit, the elastic load on the tendons is gone and you'll have to jump again. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoy.